Hi, and welcome to the second week of Spaces of Lucidity. It was really nice to see how many people saw our videos last week, and it was lovely to receive the comments, and it was extremely encouraging. So thank you to everyone who watched it. Thank you to everyone who's watching it right now, because hopefully we'll be talking about you next week. So coming straight to my topic today, I have a theory to propose or share or discuss if you're going to comment on it. You know, it is very commonplace to hear people say that just because they are rich, they have lost value for money. Now, I think this is a sentence that we've heard in all countries, all languages, in all races and cultures. So, obviously, the meaning behind it is that just because somebody has an abundance of that particular thing, they have lost relative value for it. So, somebody who doesn't have it is obviously going to value it a little more. So, my theory is that just as we have created social hierarchy when it comes to money and economics, or economic social status is actually a term now, just like that, we are beginning to knowingly or unknowingly, I don't know, you tell me, a social hierarchy as with regards to intelligence and knowledge. Now, I'd like to quote one example here, and this is something that I could completely relate to and which I saw in a series. Lo and behold, Sex and the City. In Sex and the City, Carrie Bradshaw returns home one day and she writes about her friend Miranda, who's dating a man who's a truck driver on a construction site. And she sits down and writes about how have we created social hierarchy so strong that it is even difficult for us to love someone who is not at par, so to say, with your social standing. So similarly, I think there's something similar going on when it comes to sharing of information, discussing ideas, sharing knowledge, lending a helping hand to thoughts. You can lend a helping hand to a blind person who wants to cross the road. You can lend a helping hand to someone who's hungry. You can lend a helping hand to someone who's in need of shelter. Why is it so difficult for most people to lend a helping hand when it comes to thoughts or knowledge or intelligence? So I have a theory which says that just as people lose relative value for money when they have too much of it, so do intelligent or knowledgeable people lose relative value for their knowledge. So I believe, or in my opinion, people begin to squander or misuse or abuse knowledge when they begin to condescend the others who might not seem as knowledgeable or intelligent as them. For a simple example, if I were to walk up, or if any X person were to walk up to someone else and say, hey, do you know how to clean a camera lens, for example, I don't know, for just the top of my head. And if you know how to clean a camera lens, would you help that person and show him how to clean a camera lens? Or would you say, Google it, dude? Now, I completely understand when it comes to something like that. When people say, Google it, dude, I understand why they say it, I understand how they mean it. It's very encouraging to be a self-learner. But at the same time, I believe, or through my experience, I have learned that when I learn something from someone, from a living entity, may it be a dog, may it be a cat, may it be a human being, there is just so much more that I receive with that information. And it's not just dry, to the point information. It comes with that person's experience of it. It comes with that person's tips and tricks of that knowledge. And of course, we also risk intervening our natural learning process, or, you know, we risk being influenced, so to say. But I think what we receive while learning from an individual is much more than what you would receive from reading a quick article on the internet. Of course, books are a different case, because books build a plot, books give you so much more information than what an article would. And same follows with a person. A person's like a living, breathing article, walking, talking article, and like an information center. So why not share what you know? So I think that we should not have this kind of social hierarchy where knowledge is so difficult to gain from another person. I mean, I think as human beings, we were given the gift of speech, we were given the gift of thought, we were given the gift of touch and interpretation and perception. From the gift of speech was born the art of communication. So when did we reach this point in our lives when it became difficult for us to communicate with a fellow being? Communicate ideas, communicate thoughts, communicate feelings, communicate knowledge, share knowledge. So to end today's piece, I'd like to share a quote by Louis L'Amour. I've written it down here and it says, "Knowledge is like money. To be of value, it must circulate. And in circulating, it can increase in quantity and hopefully in value." So that's all that I had to say for today. Watch out for Abhishek's column on Wednesday. As you can see here, he's right here. And we are painting a wall in our office. And Abhishek is going to talk about spaces of lucidity. So I don't think you should miss that. If you liked what I said today, I hope to receive a lot of comments. Please hit subscribe and see you next week. Ciao!